All right, you ready for some rapid fire questions?
I'll go as fast as I possibly can.
Okay, all right. Well, we'll start off with an easy one. What's your favorite fruit?
Favorite fruit? Oh, there's so many. Passion fruit comes to mind.
Ooh.
It's expensive.
Unique choice.
Unless you're in New Zealand.
What's the best smell?
Oh, passion fruit.
What's the worst smell?
Oh, well, the first one that comes to mind is actually, I've got it, it's sort of a good smell. The smell of burning solder flux. I kind of like it, but it's probably horrible and you get, you know, you start to grow horns or something.
I think I've got enough. I'm starting to grow. Yeah. You can pick one vacation spot for the rest of your life. Where are you going?
A vacation spot?
Yeah.
St. Martin. Okay. The water's clear and you can see the sharks from a distance, I suppose.
Better from a distance than up close, yeah. I think. What time of day are you most productive?
Oh, all day, every day. But I'm an early riser. I've been getting up at 5. And I find these little segments of time. 9 to 1 actually is good. That's usually when I do my videos for my school. And that's this nonstop intense period.
All right. On a good day, how many chickens do you think you could reasonably carry?
I've seen it done by a professional. In Indonesia, there was a guy driving down the freeway with chickens tied to his legs on a moped. Or maybe it was not a big motorcycle, medium to small size motorcycle. And the chickens were alive and looking around while he's going 60 miles an hour down the freeway. And he probably had, I'm going to say conservatively, 25 chickens attached to his legs. I don't think I could get anywhere close to that. Although I did develop some chicken speak as a kid, just since they were on the property, my mom had them. And so I'll do my best chicken. Right, I would sit there and I would go.
That's pretty convincing. I think you could probably at least get a few in tow behind you, just following you, sort of. A, yeah.
Yeah, that's. And we had one of every kind.
There you go. All right. What is your favorite mode of transportation?
Oh, I like the feet. The bike's okay as long as I stay away from the tram tracks. Yeah, anything where I'm not in. I like being not inside a vehicle if possible.
Okay. All right, you get to pick one guitar for the rest of your life. What does it have and what pickups are in it?
It's going to be the Kikasui Fireman by Ibanez. It's got the biggest neck possibly that I've ever played. Amazing tone. And it's got all the stuff from the Kikasui sake bottle on it. And what about it? What would I do? Or what?
Oh, pickups. It was what, but yes, that
guitar. The pickups are DiMarzio Air Classics, which are just really reliable, normal, great-sounding pickups.
Agreed. What's your desert island movie?
Desert island movie? I get to have a movie on a desert island.
Oh, yeah. You've got a TV, but it only plays one movie.
Well, Spinal Tap comes to mind. Amadeus. Those are both music movies. Probably. Well... Yeah, I don't know if I can narrow it down to one, but Spinal Tap came to my head first.
Okay. So. High replay value on Spinal Tap. Who is your favorite historical figure?
Oh, let's see. I was saying about Ben Franklin the other day, because he seemed like a person that had a sense of humor, but also he like worked hard, invented a lot of stuff, managed to get through life without great hair. And had a memorable, you know, you could, his last name was also a first name, so maybe that's a bonus.
Yes, some versatility. Yeah. Another question I had actually was if you could pick another first name, what would you be if not Paul?
Oh, well, my dad wanted to name me Marlon Brando Gilbert, and my mom vetoed it, but I ended up naming my son Marlon because I always thought that'd be kind of cool to be Marlon. But I wanted to name my son Ice Cream Cone Gilbert. I kind of knew that wasn't going to fly, but I thought, you know, anytime anyone would know, you know, his name, they would smile, and smiling is good.
That's true. Marlon's a happy name, too, though.
Yeah.
What word is most overused?
It used to be dude, but I don't hear that as much anymore. Well, I mean, the overused ones you might be for a reason. Like you kind of need the.
True.
Yeah, but overused isn't like you shouldn't use it. For me, what was the one I used too much? I didn't know it, or I wouldn't have overused it. I guess what it is the soft G, where, you know, instead of picking, I'm picking.
Okay.
And I didn't ever want to be a person that did that, but I've started doing it, and I've started not to mind. Now, maybe I haven't heard it back yet, but I've started to be okay with the soft G.
It's good. It's fun. It's, you know, it's friendly. It's fun sounding.
A picking and a grinning.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you can't, if you're picking and grinning, you know, that doesn't sound as fun as picking.
Pick scratching.
Yeah, right. Exactly. All right, you get a time machine, but it can only either go forward or backward. What do you choose?
Well, backward's safer because I know have a better idea of what's there. I'd probably go backward, but then I'd go see some concerts. You know, Beethoven, when he was conducting, you know, all the classical people. I'd want to be there when Shostakovich premiered the Fifth Symphony. And maybe that the first, who was the guy that wrote the Stravinsky?
Mm-hmm.
To see if the audience really did.
The Rite of Spring.
Yeah. See what really happened there.
You get to replace one instrument in the orchestra with the electric guitar. Which one is it?
Oh, might not be a good move. but let's see. If I'm sitting there and I'm playing, I don't know, like the piccolo or something, because it's high. I learned I did it all with the high. It's probably better with the real. I actually just bought an upright bass, and man, it sounds good. Hard to play, but this is probably better for the Ted Nugent. You know? That's kind of what it's built for.
I'm not sure if Ted. I wonder if Ted's ever done any orchestral, appearances.
There's time.
Yeah, there is still time. All right. What is something that you learned this week?
This week, I learned that I've learned a bunch of things. I learned how to make a click track by hand, so I can play these Mr. Big songs. The parts where there's no drums. I've got a hockey puck that you stomp on. It's got some kind of microphone inside. I took a drumstick and just put it on my knee and hit, you know, made a click that way, and then used my Stephen Slate samples to make it into a snare sound or a side stick, you know, like tick, 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 tick. And then, you know, I got most of them right, but, you know, ones where I didn't, I could move it around, and I got a really nice click track. And I realized, you know, why stop there? Now I can put a click to anything. If I need to, and if there's a section that needs it, and it's so much easier to do by hand than it was trying to do the way you're supposed to do it with the tempo map and all that stuff, and which I did as well and failed.